The Chico Unified School District is making sure that students' needs are met both emotionally and socially. So this may mean changes to school libraries so that kids will feel represented by the books on the shelves.
My expectation and my hope would be that the district is actively listening to parents and their needs for their children.
Parent Shelley Villalobos wants to know her daughter Antoinette's curriculum before she starts school in the fall.
What are the subjects? What are the key bullet points?
Hooker Oak Elementary principal Emily Mullins says it starts with teachers connecting with their students.
A student who was adopted might feel uncomfortable or alienated from a family assignment.
Here's what the district's framework looked like last year. Very specific and complex, and this year their goals are looking broader.
You have to make it broad so that it covers everything, because there's a lot to be covered.
That could mean anything that plays with people's emotions.
Board members Matt Tennis and Eileen Robinson tell me the new plan could affect students in accelerated math programs.
We don't segregate, that we integrate as far as student capabilities. And it's like, you know, floating a boat. They all float higher when they're all floating together.
People do have unique strengths and weaknesses, and we need to celebrate the strengths in our students, no matter what color they are or, you know, where they come from or what their demographic is.
The next step is for Chico Unified staff to write a general mission statement that can accomplish the board's three goals. And then this will be presented at the June 23rd meeting. In Chico, Tori Apodaca, Action News Now, coverage you can count on.